Good morning, Facebook Live. I'm Susan Baez. Welcome to Drink from the Well Fridays. Oh my gosh, I am so excited for today, for the study today. He's so good. I just want to share with you guys this song that God gave, and it's from Psalm 16. Psalm 16, 5 through 8, and it says, Lord, you alone are my inheritance, my cup of blessing. You guard all that is mine. Lord, you alone are my inheritance. You are my cup of blessing. You alone are my inheritance. You are my cup of blessing. You guard all that's mine. You guard all that's mine, oh Lord. We are singing the scriptures, right? There's something that makes it just go really, really deep when we sing the word of the Lord. It helps us memorize it. It helps us get it in deep, right? Helps renew our mind and transform us into new creatures. So let's sing that again. Six says, the land you have given me is a pleasant land. What a wonderful inheritance. Verse 7, I will bless the Lord who guides me. Even at night, my heart instructs me. I know the Lord is with me. I will not be shaken, for he is right beside me. Oh, that's a promise. It's good, right? Oh, you have given you Lord gave me this song years ago. It was just singing the scriptures, right? And this idea that He is our inheritance, He is our cup of blessing, and that He guards everything that belongs to us. Isn't that amazing? That the Lord Himself, He guards it. He stands guard for the things that belong to us so that they can't be stolen from the enemy. So awesome. Right? That He has drawn the lines for us in pleasant places, and He guards them. Hallelujah. Ooh, all right. Well, good morning. Good morning, Susan and Selena and Andre. Good morning, Eva. I'm so glad you guys have joined. So excited for this word. This word that God is our inheritance, right? He is rich. He has riches for us on so many different levels, right? He is our provision. He is our provider. He is our supply, right? Go through scripture. You hear it. You see it over and over and over and over again that the Lord provides for us, right? So a couple weeks ago, I was talking about the secret place, right? If you missed that one, go back and look at it. It was so good. The Lord is just reminding, and I was brushing my teeth that morning, and the Lord said the secret place, right? And, you know, so many times, like, I can get caught in, like, oh, I have to do this teaching, right? Like, what do I have to do? But those are these messages that He gives are for us, right? They're for me and they're for us because I'm sharing them, right? And so He was telling me the secret place, right? And so I was like, yay, good, let's teach about the secret place. But He also wanted me, He was calling me to come back and spend time with Him daily, right? And I've done that, and I spend time with Him, like when I'm doing dishes and when I'm going about my day, right? But I had gotten away from, like, dedicated time that I cut everything else out and I just spend with Him. And I used to do that when my kids were little. I would spend like 2 hours a day during their nap time, and I would just hang out with God, right? And I knew that He wanted to call me back and call me back to that place. And then, so I did it. I was like, Lord, I want to dedicate this time for You again, right? And so my day can often be so busy and I don't have like good hours in the afternoon anymore, but I have the morning, right? And so He was like waking me up to come back. So for the past two mornings, I've woken up at 5:30, an hour before I usually do, to spend time with Him and to hang out with Him. And it's been so awesome. I'm so excited to do that again. But yesterday was the first day I started it, and I was just so high, you guys. Like, Jesus met me, we hung out together. It was so awesome, you know. We were gonna go to the library, but we didn't quite make it. We just stayed on the stairs going and just hanging out with Him, and it's so wonderful, right? But so then I was getting ready for soaking yesterday, and I opened up my Bible and I saw this. It's a hard to see, but it is a word that my friend Lisa, who comes to soaking, wrote for me. And I just read it over quickly, you know, getting ready to go to soaking. And I was just like, oh yeah, I remember that word. It's so good. And so I got in the car and I was just hanging out with more about Jesus. But let me read this to you, okay? It says, Susan, I pray this verse, and the verse that was on the back, over you, and that all your inheritance is released into now form, to into the now, from the eternal riches in Christ Jesus. I pray this verse over you, and that all your inheritance is released into now from the eternal riches in Christ Jesus. And then it said, she said, spend your inheritance because your Father is wealthy, and you are displaying His abundant life, truth, and way, right? It was so good. And so I read over it. I'd read it before, but it wasn't really connecting. And I got in the car and I was just worshiping and just so full of the Lord and full of His presence, right? And then it just hit me, like, spend His riches. Lord, wow! You know? And I was so high, and I did that video if you saw it from yesterday, right? I was just like, yes, spend His riches. And then I got over the high, and then I was like, what does that mean? Right? I was like, wait a minute. right? And there's so many levels. I mean, I get it on one level, right? But I feel like there's a deeper thing that he wanted to do. And so that's what we're going to talk about today. I'm so excited. Okay, but first I have a question for you, and I want you to write it in the comments below. What does that mean to you? When you hear me say that, if the Lord would speak that to you, which I believe if you're watching this right now, he is speaking it to you right now, right? What does that mean to you? If the Lord says, spend my riches, comment below. Okay, put your comments below. Even if you're watching this later, write the comments below. What does it mean to you? Okay, all right, let's go to his word. Philippians 4, 18 through 20. And Philippians was written by Paul, right? If you have read my second book, we have a wonderful relationship with Paul, don't we? Or he was Saul at that time. But okay, so Philippians 4, 18 through 20. And it says, at the moment, I have all I need and more. Okay? I am generously supplied with the gifts you sent me from Epaphroditus, I think that's what it is, okay? They are sweet-smelling sacrifice. The gifts are a sweet-smelling sacrifice that is acceptable and pleasing to God. This same God who takes care of me will supply all of your needs from his glorious riches. Okay? Whew. Let's read that again. And this same God who takes care of me will supply. Did you hear that promise? So good. Will supply all your needs from his glorious riches, which have been given to us in Christ Jesus. Now all glory to God, our Father, forever and ever. Amen. Okay? So good. All right, so when I first heard that phrase, spend my riches, this is the verse that came to mind, right? Out of his glorious riches, he supplies all of our needs, and Paul says, and more, right? And at first, I didn't even realize that this, when I heard it, it's a commandment, right? When the Lord says, spend my riches, he was giving me a command, all right? And so he's not saying, if you feel like it, if you want to, you know, if it's convenient, if it's a good time, you know, he's saying, spend my riches. Spend my riches, commandment, okay? And I didn't think of money right away. Like right away, that's not the first thing that came to mind, right? Maybe it is for you. Like when he says, spend my riches, I didn't necessarily think of right away money. I thought of like joy, right? Joy and freedom and love and grace and mercy and loving kindness and all of those things that God is riches that I would think of as God's riches, right? That we get all the fruit of the Spirit, all of that stuff, all of the abundance of joy that's in his presence that we get to walk in, right? That's what I thought of right away. To spend his riches, to give it away, right? Anytime that I have to give it, just to give it away. But when I went to Philippians 4, and I'm looking at this verse, 4, 18 through 20, right, that we just read, Paul is talking about money, right? That's the first verse that came to mind. It's out of his glorious riches. Paul is talking about money here. He received a gift, a financial gift from the city of Philippi, from the church in the city of Philippi, right? And he was thanking them for it. And he was like, yes, it is a sweet smelling sacrifice that is acceptable and pleasing to God. Right? And then he's praying for them and he's saying, I believe that the same God who takes care of me, because through them, through their gift, God was taking care of him, right? He will supply all your needs from his glorious riches, which have been given to us in Christ Jesus. So he is talking about money, right? He's talking about out of God's riches that God will supply all your needs because they had just given to him. So God is going to take care of them and give it back to him, give it back to them, right? It's so cool. And so it's out of his glorious riches, right? And God is rich. Like I was talking about on the video yesterday, right? God is rich. Let's prove it in the word. He says, I have no need for a bull from your stall or goats from your pens. Okay, remember, this is Old Testament. This is Psalm 50, right? And he is not talking like those were the riches of those days, where how many animals that you had, and you know, oh, that was a show of how rich a man was, is how much cattle did he have? How many sheep did he have? How many goats did he have, right? Okay, so he says, I have no need for a bull from your stall or goats from your pens, for every beast of the forest is mine. The cattle on a thousand hills, right? And some versions say, I own the cattle on a thousand hills. That's Psalm 59 through 10. And then another verse is, nor is he served by human hands, as if he needed anything, right? God doesn't need anything from us, because he himself gives all men life and breath and everything else, right? So everything else, that's all of the supply, everything that we need is given to us by God's hands, right? We don't need to give to him. Like when we're giving our tithes and our offerings and all of that stuff, we are giving to him. It's like we're giving to him, but he doesn't need it. He asks us to give because he knows that it's good for us, right? And there's a spiritual principle here that he wants us to realize, because when we reap what we sow, right? And if we're sowing in blessing, if we're sowing in love, and if we're sowing in joy, and we're sowing in peace, and we're sowing in forgiveness, and we're sowing in all of this stuff, and we're sowing financially also, right? Then God has something to work with, and he can multiply it and give it back to us, because we're sowing in these things and we're going to reap it, okay? So all of our supply comes from him. He doesn't need us. He asks us to partner with him, right? When he says, spend my riches, it was an invitation for me. It's a commandment, really. Wow, right? For me to spend his riches. For me to come into the fullness, for us as well, to come into the fullness of what is that? What does that look like? What are the riches that you have for me? What is the inheritance from Psalm 16, right? You alone are my inheritance, my cup of blessing. You guard all that's mine. You've given me a pleasant land. Okay, and back in this Old Testament time in Psalms, when that was written, it literally was an inheritance of land they had been given from God, right? Going into the land of Canaan. What does that mean for us in this day? What is our inheritance? Right? And you know, guys, I don't really have any answers today. I'm not here to answer these questions for you. I believe that God wants us to think about this and to ask ourselves some questions, right? So I'm asking them, and let's ask them together. All right. So there is an and more, right? Because like Paul said, at this moment, because we know when we're walking with the Lord, right? We have ups and downs. It can change at any moment. But Paul is saying, at this moment, I have all that I need and more. Right? And I think there's two places for us, two lessons for us in that concerning this, right? We can walk in, and God wants us to walk in that place, that first place of having all we need, right? That he is our supply. That he is our provision. So that means we're not worried, we're not anxious, we're not, you know, wondering where it's coming from. That he wants us to grow in that, and walking in faith, walking in knowing that he is our supply, that he is our provision, that he is going to take care of us, right? Even when it's shaky, and some of us have to live through times when maybe jobs aren't there, right? Or we've all gone through seasons in our lives when we've lived that way, like totally reliant, like, Lord,
I need you for everything right now, and I have to have you come through, or I don't know how this is going to work, right? And so we have testimonies of that. All of us do, right? Of God supremely, sovereignly, absolutely taking care of us when we did not see how that was going to happen. And I want you to share that too, right? Comment on that too. Share an example. Let's encourage each other of when God totally came through for you, financially especially, right? When you were waiting on the Lord for something and God just totally came through and did it for you. But I'm also wanting you to comment on that because you need to remember too. We need to remember when God came through for us, especially when we're living in something hard, right? Okay, so that's the first step, right? Is understanding that God is the supplier of all of our needs, okay? But then we also want the end more, right? Just like Paul said, you supply all that I need. I have all that I need at this moment and more. So what does the end more look like? Remember, I'm not answering any questions today. I'm just asking, right? What does the end more look like? Okay. You guys, we say this all the time, right? Faith. Faith, faith, faith. We can do nothing. It all starts and ends with faith. It is our faith that pleases God, right? And faith is the currency of heaven. Faith is the currency of the kingdom. So how do we use our faith as currency to spend his riches? Right? How do we do that? I have a quote here from Graham Cook that always stayed with me, and I tried to find it online. I'm not even sure if this is exactly how the quote went, but it was something like this. If you do what you would do when you have it, if you do what you would do if you had it before you get it, then you are sure to get it. Right? I'll say that again. If you do what you would do if you had it before you get it, you are sure to get it. Right? So if you had an endless supply of money in the natural, right? Like if that wasn't an option, what would you do? What would you do with it? And so Graham Cook is saying, if you do what you would do if you already had it before you get it, then you're sure to get it, right? Because that's faith. Faith is the substance. It is the guarantee of things that we can't see yet, right? It's like receiving a check for $1 million and holding on to it. And it doesn't mean anything yet, right? Because it's just a piece of paper. But we believe in that check. We know it. If we know that the person who wrote it is good, right? Then we have $1 million, right? We would go for it and act like we have it because we do have it, even though we don't really have it yet, right? So that's faith. Believing in what we receive from the Lord out of the riches of our inheritance from him, right? Before we have it, before we see it, like we're able to see it with the eyes of our heart, with our faith, with our understanding, before we get it, before we see it in the natural, right? It's faith, and that is the currency of heaven. That's what we need. Faith, 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 right? So this morning, remember I was saying I'm dedicating time between 5:30 and like 6:45 to spend with Jesus in the morning. And I was with him this morning and I was like, Lord, where do you want to take me? Where do we go today? You know, is all these heavenly places that are available to us, right? And so I saw a picture of him on a dock and out into water, a body of water, okay? And he's at the end of this wooden dock. And I'd been here before. I know where this is, right? This is the ocean of his goodness. I love this heavenly place, right? There is an ocean of God's goodness, and we can go there. I think I have another teaching on that from who knows how long back, but just go look and you can find it, right? The ocean of his goodness. All right, so I knew Jesus was standing there and I'm like, oh, yay, I love this place. Let's go, right? And so I start running down the dock and I'm running down to greet him. And, you know, we have this amazing greeting as we always do. And I love you, Jesus. And he tells me he loves me and all of this. So good, right? And we're just like hanging out with each other. And so then he's like, okay, are you ready? Because when we've gone here before, what I saw was that Jesus stood at the end of the dock and he took me by the hand and he was like, okay, ready? 1, 2, 3. And we jumped in, right? We jumped in the water and we went all the way down to the bottom and we stood on the bottom of the ocean of God's goodness, okay, on the sea bottom. And he's like, don't worry about it. You can breathe. You're with me. It's fine. Don't freak out, right? Even though we're underwater. Okay, and so then we start walking, and we're walking on the bottom of the sea, of the ocean, of God's goodness, and we get to a treasure chest. Okay, and all this I've seen before, but I saw it again this morning. We do similar things. And so there's this treasure chest, but it's much, much bigger than it was before when I first saw it. It's huge. It's huge, huge, huge. It's like twice the size that it was when I first saw it, right? And so it's so big that Jesus goes to one of the end of it to open it up. And last time Jesus just opened it, but this time he's like, I think I need a little help here. He invited me in to help him open this treasure chest. Okay, significant. It's always significant. So I'm like, sure, Jesus, I'll help you. Even though in the back of my mind, I'm like, but you're Jesus, you can do it, right? You don't really need me. So we open the treasure chest and inside I see a book like I saw before. And he told me before in this book, he was teaching me through this that he is the author and the finisher of the book of our story, right? He has it all written out, Psalm 139, right? Every day of our lives were recorded in his book before a single day had passed. He has it all there. Right? But when I was here the first time, he is the authority and the author of our book, right? You know, that word authority, the word author is in that word. And so he was like, I have given you authority in me to write. Because we do, we've been given authority in Christ Jesus, right? So he was like, in this book, he gave me a pen, he put it in my hand, and then he put his hand over my hand, and he was like, what do you want to write? I've given you the authority. What's in your life right now that you'd like to see, that you want to write into your book? Right? And his hand is over mine, so I have the authority in him to write. What do I want to see? What do I want to have happen? What do I have faith for? Right? What do I want to erase? I can erase things. You know, this past summer, I was struggling with disappointment, right? And the Lord was just showing me that I didn't have to deal with that. I could just erase it. And we did. We erased it together. And thank you, Jesus. I have new freedom from disappointment in my life, right? We have the authority in Christ to write our book, to write our story, right? What do we want to see? What do we not want to have anymore? What do we want to walk in? Because it's by faith, right? And so I saw that, remembering all that I saw before, but this time when we opened the treasure chest together, it's huge, right? And on all of what that book was sitting on, all of the stuff that was underneath inside the treasure chest was treasure. This time I saw that there was literal treasure in there. Okay? And so there were pieces of gold and there were jewels and there were coins and there were instruments. I saw instruments. But I just had this sense that it was all filled with just stuff. Remember Psalm 16? You are alone. You alone are my inheritance, Lord. You are my cup of blessing. You guard all that is mine. Are you guys with me? Are you getting it? He has an inheritance for us. It is a wonderful inheritance. And I'm asking right now, what's in your treasure chest? What would God have for you?
What are the things that you long for? What are the things that you've always wanted to do or to be or to experience? He has a treasure. He has treasure for us, right? And it's stored up in heavenly places. And we can go there and get them, right? Like we were talking about a couple weeks ago with the song from the library. I had to go get it. He said, go get it. You know where it is, right? So, okay, so we open this treasure chest. There's the book that I saw before. There's all of this stuff, all of this treasure in there. And so I pick up one of the coins. Because remember, God said, spend your riches, spend my riches, right? And so I look at this coin and I turn it over, and written on the coin is the word faith, right? Because faith is the currency of heaven, right? It is a trade. There is always a trade. There is an exchange that we have available to us. So we take our coin, our currency of heaven, which is faith, right? And we can exchange it. We can trade it, because that's what we're doing, right? We have our paper money, right? And we exchange it. I forgot to turn the phone off. Sorry, guys. We exchange it for the things that we want, right? Like if we go to the store and we're going to the groceries and I need food, so I'm gonna give you some paper money, all right? Or my credit card or whatever, and exchange it and I get food back, right? And so it's the same in the kingdom. We have the currency of heaven, which is faith, and we take it and exchange it for goods. Oh my gosh, you guys. We exchange it for his goods. That is so good. Oh, you guys getting it, right? It's so good for his goods. Remember, we're in the ocean of his goodness. Oh my gosh, I love it. He's so, so awesome, right? Our Father is wealthy. He is abundant. He wants to give us his riches. He has all of this stored up for us. And if it wasn't true, he wouldn't have said so, right? He wouldn't have said that out of my glorious riches, I will give to you, right? We just have to have faith. We have to go get it. We have to make the exchange, right? I could have money in my bank. I could be sitting at home at my table with an empty plate in front of me and like, okay, Lord, right? Where's my food? I'm hungry. I'm ready to eat, right? But is that how it works in the natural? It's like, no, the food doesn't magically appear. We have to go get it. Right? We have to go to the grocery store. We have to exchange our money for this food, right? And we have to come home and cook it and eat it, right? It doesn't just appear. And God is teaching us something here, you guys, right? We have to go get it. We have to grow in this. And I feel like, okay, you guys know me. You know I'm not that harsh, right? But we are coming to the end of this season where the church has to learn how to get up and get the things of heaven. You guys, we've been sitting at the table for too long, just waiting for God and saying, Lord, where is it? Feed me, right? But he wants us to grow up. He wants us to understand how the kingdom works so that we can move in it. We have to go get it. We have to learn how. Right? And it was so full of joy. It was so full of joy in his presence yesterday when he gave me this command. And yes, it's not a striving thing, right? It is a joyful, joyful thing. We get to spend his riches. You guys, we get to. Our Father is rich. He is abundant. He has everything. Everything is available to us. We have every spiritual blessing, right? In Christ Jesus. What do you need? I feel like he's saying that to us this morning. What do you need? What do you want? Spend my riches. Spend my riches.
I don't want to get to heaven and see that there were riches available to me that I didn't get because I was sitting there waiting. Oh, Lord, help us. Teach us, God. Let us understand how to receive in your kingdom, how to move, how to go get it, Lord. How to get the things you have for us, because it's not just for us. He wants to bless us. He wants to have abundance, us to have abundance so that we can pour out, so that we can be his hands and feet on the earth. So we can go and we can do what he's called us to do, and we can be who he's called us to be. Right? So good. So it's time, guys. Yesterday during soaking, we were singing, wake up, oh sleeper, rise from the dead and be filled with light, right? We were just praying and calling, interceding for all of us, me included, guys. I'm in this, right? Because he commanded me to spend his riches because I know I'm not walking in the fullness of what he has for me. I'm not spending it. I'm not acting like I already have it. And I can just walk in it, right? If I already had $1 million, what would I do with it? Do that. Start moving towards that, and I guarantee you will have it, right? I have a couple of examples of this that I want to share with you, because I always feel like we need real life scenario here. Like, what am I talking about, right? So I have a couple of examples where I did move in this, and one of them was my second CD. And I knew I wanted to go in the studio because for my first CD, okay, guys, it was bootleg. All right. It was like totally. Okay, but I did it. It was a step. It's called Small Beginnings for a reason, right? We had to move towards that. So the second CD, I knew I wanted to go to the studio and had all these songs that the Lord had given me. And I had my friend Andre, who's probably still on here, that just was amazing and did all this music. And I'm like, okay, I have to go to the studio. That means I have to pay for studio time, right? To go in the studio. And I'm like, Lord, I don't know if I have it. I don't know. I don't even know how much this is going to cost to do a whole CD, right? I have no idea. But I just felt like he was like, just do it. Just go for it. And you will have it when you need it. And so I did. And guys, I had it when I needed it, right? Every single time we were going to the studio, I had the money to pay for studio time, right? Somebody would ask me to come sing somewhere and I would get a blessing from that, or, you know, whatever it is I would, and I had what I needed. He gave it to me. And I was able to do what I needed to do. I had to step out in faith, right? I had to call and make an appointment with my studio guy, right? Eric Terlizzi, he's awesome. And say, okay, yes, I want to come make an appointment, even if I had nothing in my account at the time when I did that, right? I had to just go for it. But when I did go to the studio and I needed to pay him, I had it. Right? So we just have to step in. Like the Israelites did, they had to put their foot in the water to cross over the Jordan to get into the promised land. Right? And we can do it, guys. He wants us to. Okay, another example is I was writing my first book and had no idea. I had my manuscript and had no idea how to do this. And he was showing me every step of the way. I had an editor. I had to pay $1,500, right, to this editor. And I had no idea how I was going to do this, right? But I just went for it. And I was like, Lord, this is your story. This is your idea, and I need to go forward and I need to do this in order to get this book out, so I'm gonna go for it. And so I called her and we set it up, and she started, you know, doing my book, and I would pray like, okay, I have no idea. She was charging me by the hour, right? I have no idea how much this is gonna be. And I was able to pay as she went, so I didn't need the whole $1,500 in the beginning. But every single time I got an invoice from her, I had exactly what I needed in my account, right? We need to walk by faith, you guys. There's so much that the Lord has. So I ask you again, what do you need? What do you want? What is the inheritance that God has given you? Are you a writer? Are you an artist? Are you a singer or a songwriter? Are you wanting to start a business? And you have this idea for this business and you want to do it, but you're like, oh, well, I don't know. I don't know if I have the money. I can't do that, right? Just go for it, you guys. These are heavenly things and God is giving them to us. He gives us these desires. He gives us these gifts. He gives us these ideas, right? And he wants us to walk in it. And so we have to step out. We have to go for it because through that, so many people are going to be blessed, you guys. And then we get to be his hands and feet, right? I think about all the people that have been blessed by this book and the story that God has in this. And it feels like it's a simple thing, but that's my call. That's what God had for me to do. That was the riches that he gave me, right? And so he wanted me to spend it, to do it. And so in this, and things that I don't even know are gonna still yet, people that I even know yet are gonna be blessed by it, right? You guys are getting it, okay? You get it, we just have to go for it. We just have to step out and do it by faith. Do it scared, do it trembling, right? But just do it. And it's okay if you have to start with something small. Okay, because he wants us to build up our faith. It might be just, you know, rent for that month, or, you know, how am I going to pay my phone bill, or whatever it is, like, but start. But even if you're the level of just supplying my needs, that is a wonderful place to be, but know that there is more. He wants us to walk in the more, right? So I always want to leave you guys with strategy. Okay, so how do we do this? And like I said, I don't know if I have any answers for you because I feel like it's always different. It's gonna be different. It's gonna be individual. It's gonna be going to that secret place and asking the Lord and going, maybe we go, use that heavenly place if you need to. It's completely fine. Close your eyes, see the ocean of God's goodness, jump in with him, see that treasure chest, open it up, get your faith, and then spend it. Right? Spend it. Spend his riches. Right? Maybe it's an instrument he wants you to learn. I saw instruments in those in that treasure chest, right? So go get an instrument and start picking it up. He wants us to have these things. What is in your heart? And so that's my first question for our strategy. Right? What do you need? What do you want? What is your and more that's been stirring in your heart, right? Second question, what do you have? What has the Lord already given you that he wants you to spend, right? Because some of this, it's not always only money. It is spiritual things, right? It is love, it is joy. How can I spend those things? How do you want me to spend those things, Lord? Right? How do I spend it? Where do I spend it? All these questions that we can ask the Lord that he has for us, that we can walk in, that we can get answers for from him. I don't have any answers for you, right? I know what God would call me to and what he'd call me to do, right? Even when I was doing this study, I felt like there's a huge thing that I'm like, oh my gosh, Lord, are you really saying that? Like, do you really want me to step out in faith and do this? But yes, it's huge, right? It's like, okay, God, like I have to spend it. You said spend my riches, so I have to go for it, right? You guys, it's so scary. It is scary. I get it, right? But we just have to start walking towards it, and then he will show us what to do. He'll show us how. We just determine in our heart and say yes to his command. And we say like, okay, Lord, I don't know how to do this. Show me how, right? Okay, third question. What would spending his riches look like for you right now in this season? What does that look like? Okay. And then the fourth question is, how do you do that? How do you spend it? Whatever it is that God would put on your heart, I feel like even now he's probably putting stuff on your heart. So how do you do that? How do I spend it, Lord? That's the question, okay? All right, let's pray. Lord, we just thank you. Thank you for this study, God. Thank you for this journey. Thank you for your word. That was a rhema word, God, to spend your riches, right? Thank you for speaking. Thank you for directing us. Thank you for showing us. Thank you for reminding me about the secret place and to come back, right? You're always guiding us. You're always leading us. Thank you for showing us how, God. Thank you for showing us what. What are the riches that we have? What is the inheritance that you've been given? Right? And a good way to try to find that is like, look at what's in your family line. Look at what your mother or your father were good at. Look at those desires that you have, right? That you want to do. Those are the things that you've been given to spend. So thank you, Lord, for that thing, those things that you've given to us, that you've put in us. And I just pray that those things would be activated right now in the name of Jesus for everybody who's watching. That it would just start to burn. It would start to be burning in us that we cannot hold on to these things anymore, that we have to spend them. We have to give them away. Right? Thank you, Lord, for giving us the authority to go and get it. The authority to do it, right? That we wouldn't sit at the table any longer, Lord, like children and say, feed me, God, but we would learn how to go get it. We would learn how to spend this currency called faith. That we would start, even starting small. It's just a start. Thank you, Jesus, for the small. We won't despise the day of small beginnings. Because every step sends us on a journey and deeper and deeper into this faith walk, deeper and deeper into the inheritance, deeper into the promises that you have for us. So yes, let it be activated in us right now in Jesus' name. Give us passion, Father. Give us courage. Give us boldness. In the name of Jesus. Thank you, Lord. Amen. Woo! Amen. That was good. Wasn't that fun? So good. Oh, God is so good. He is so awesome. So, all right. So tomorrow, today's Friday, right? Tomorrow I have a book party coming up. It's gonna be in Nightdale, and it's with two other, you've probably been hearing me talking about it and seeing the flyers on my page. It's called A Night with Authors. It's with two other authors, and we're gonna be at the Hampton Inn in Nightdale at 4:00. So come on out. There's going to be worship. There's going to be food. It's going to be fun. We're going to just hang out with God and hang out with each other and see what God has for us. And my books will be there available. My body butter will be there. My tote bags and all of that stuff. And it's, I'm just excited to get together with these other ladies and just, we're doing it, you guys, right? We're just like, this is what God's given us to do. And we just love doing it. And I know that God, I'm even just praying right now that God's going to send people, even maybe somebody that's in the hotel that just walking by and like, what's this? What's going on here? They hear the worship. They hear the thing and they're just drawn to it, right? Yes, in Jesus' name, Lord, let that be. Whew. And I have a couple of other book parties coming up. I'll keep you in tune or in the loop on those. Again, if you want to host a book party, I would love to do that. You can invite your friends. You can have even neighbors, unbelievers possibly there, right? Because it's a book, it's a story, it's fiction, right? It's accessible. We can plant seeds of truth into people and into their hearts, and you never know how God's going to use that. All right. I think that's it. That's all I have for this week. I love you guys. I love you so much. Thank you for watching. Thank you for sharing the videos. Thanks for all the comments. Don't forget to comment, leave your testimonies, leave your examples of when God came through for you, right? And let's build each other up. Let's show somebody might be going through the same thing that you've gone through. Right? A couple weeks ago when I had my mom on, my friend Kristen was sharing with me that she had the same thing. She was about to go that day. Right? To have a similar testimony of what mom did. And she did have a similar testimony. We never know, guys. It's so good. God will use it. So don't be afraid to share. Share, and comment below. I love you. So good today. May the Lord bless you and keep you.
make his face to shine upon you, be gracious unto you, and give you peace. Until we meet again, I love you. Bye-bye.